Hello everyone, welcome to my channel English Excel. In this video, I am going to discuss about the most important question answer of HPLC that are frequently asked during interview. So let's begin. Question number 1. What is HPLC? High performance liquid chromatography is an analytical technique to separate, identify and quantify components in a mixture. It is the single biggest chromatography technique essential to most laboratories worldwide. Question number 2. What is the principle of HPLC? The principle of separation in normal phase mode and reverse phase mode in adsorption. When a mixture of components introduced into HPLC column, they travel according to their relative affinities towards the stationary phase. The component which are more affinity towards the adsorbent travels slower. The component which are less affinity towards the stationary phase travel faster. Question number 3. What are the mode of HPLC? HPLC modes: normal phase, polar stationary phase, non-polar mobile phase. In reverse phase, stationary phase is non-polar and mobile phase is polar. Question number 4. On the basis of modes and on the basis of elution techniques, HPLC are how many types? Based on their modes of chromatography, HPLC are two types. Number 1, normal phase mode and reverse phase mode. And on the basis of elution technique, it is also divided into two. Number 1, isochromatic separation, and number 2, gradient separation. Question number 5. What are the different parts of HPLC? Number 1, solvent reservoir. Number 2, degreaser. Number 3, solvent delivery pump. Number 4, injector. Number 5, column run. Number 6, detector. And the last one is recorder. In this diagram, you can see the all parts of HPLC system. The next question is number 6. That is, what is mobile phase in HPLC? The mobile phase, the liquid that moves solute through column. Next, question number 7. What is stationary phase in HPLC? The packing material of the column which is the immobile phase involved in the chromatography process. Column used as a stationary phase in HPLC. Next question is question number 8. That is, what is retention time? The time taken by the analyte peak to reach the detector after sample injection is called retention time. Next is question number 9. What are the advantages of HPLC? Speed, efficiency and accuracy. Compared to their chromatography technique such as TLC, HPLC is the extremely quick and efficient. It uses a pump rather than gravity to force a liquid solvent through a solid adsorbent material, which different chemical components separating out as they move at different speeds. The next question, question number 10. Why do we get negative peak in HPLC? A negative peak means that there is less adsorbance while the peak is passing through the detector than when the mobile phase is passing through. It is likely due to the mobile phase has more adsorbance than the analyte at the monitored wavelength. The next is question number 11. What is RT and RRT in HPLC? The amount of time it takes for the compound to pass through the column is the retention time. And the relative retention time, RRT, is the comparison of RT of one compound to another. The next question is question number 12. What is USP telling factor? The telling factor is a measure of peak telling. It is defined as the distance from the front slope of the peak to the back slope divided by twice the distance from the center line of the peak to the front slope, with all measurement made at the 5% of the maximum peak height. In this figure, you can easily understand how to calculate the telling factor. The formula is also given in this figure. The next question is 13. What is needle wash in HPLC? The needle in the HPLC system is used to introduce the sample into the mobile fridge so that it can be separated on the HPLC column. The needle wash is used to clean the needle after an injection. Next, question number 14. What is resolution in HPLC? This is the most important system suitability parameter of HPLC, that is called resolution. The resolution of a illusion is the quantitative measure of how well the two illusion peak can be differentiated in a chromatography separation. It is defined as the difference in the retention times between the two peaks divided by the combined width of the illusion peak. Next is question number 15. What is RRF value in HPLC? Relative response factor is an alternate method for the determination of the quantity of the impurities present in the pharmaceutical products, and amount of the impurity can be calculated with the help of peak area of the compounds. Next is question number 16. What is degassing in HPLC? Degassing is the term used to describe dissolved gases coming out of solution. This phenomenon can also occur in HPLC system when rough surface produces nucleation sites for bubble formation. In HPLC analysis, the problem produced by bubble formation can largely be prevented by degassing the mobile phase. The next question is question number 17. What is SST in HPLC? SST is commonly used to verify resolution, column efficiency, and repeatability of a chromatography system to ensure its adequacy for a particular analysis. According to the United States Pharmacopoeia (USP) and the Internal Conference of Harmonization (ICH), SST is an integral part of many analytical procedures. Next is question number 18. What is LOD and LOQ in HPLC? Limit of detection (LOD) and limit of quantification (LOQ) are two important performance characteristics in method validation. LOD and LOQ are terms used to describe the smallest concentration of an analyte that can be reliably measured by an analytical procedure. Next is question number 19. What is integration of HPLC? Chromatographic peak integration defines as an operation on which the area under the chromatographic peak is measured. The measurement is based on the integral technique of splitting the peak into a large number of rectangles, which are then summed to provide an estimate of the total area under the peak. There are some integration parameters such as minimum area, telling, fronting, etc. The next question is question number 20. What are the parameters of HPLC calibration? Number 1, flow rate accuracy, that you also know as a pump module. Number 2, injector accuracy. Number 3, carryover. Number 4, system precision. Number 5, wavelength accuracy. Number 6, injector linearity. Number 7, detector linearity. Number 8, gradient performance check. It is also known as GPV. And the last one is column open temperature accuracy.